Did I hear mouse cursor? Where's my butt? That's just really loud. Alright, anyway. Started. This game also has infinite continues, so I don't need passwords like I thought I did during the match. Unknown to many, mankind was almost destroyed by the Neo-Sapiens 2 years before the Neo-Sapien War even started. This is that story. Here's a boat. Words. The Neo-Sapiens blue. To time police. Late class, you go to jail. Could have done this. I kind of want a still of that. Hello, impending disaster. How are you? I have to go back and get a screenshot of who could have done this. I remember it like it was yesterday. I love that robot's walk animation. It is the best thing in this game. Oh, you can skip the tutorials, I didn't know that. I also kind of really like the health mechanic in this. The rotary dial health bar thing is pretty cool. So who am I during this part? Look at that swag walk on that robot. That's a treasure master walk right there. I've been playing God Eater, using the analog stick. I hate the analog stick. I guess you just walk on your head. I was just faster than what I did in my match. Like, everybody died on this stage in the first match, or like their first few attempts through. It's kind of hard. You have to know what's coming up. Also, all the score count crap. I like how you can push the body along the ground. Desecrate this man's carcass. And then stomp all over it. That's the end of the stage. That's right. So I guess we were the leader in the space missions. I thought we were Rita. I guess she's in this part I just did. And the dude that eats is in the fighting part. Or something. Were we not Rita? Did we not just stomp around the city committing war crimes? Also, the space missions were pretty tough. Like, these are probably the hardest missions just because there's so much crap on the screen. This thing like me is home in on here. They have to destroy those and take damage. That's what I learned real quick. Hello Scorpion, y'all. And I had to play this in Cusa Grande blind. It was quite the experience. So I won that match by quite a lot. I was honestly surprised. I thought I was doing kinda bad. But everyone got stuck on the stage after this one. I think it's the stage after. Also this boss sucks. Yup, motion sickness with all the wobbling. And if you get locked on, you basically die. And when you die, you have to do the whole stage over again. There's no checkpoints. You like this? The background wiggles when you move, and you're constantly bouncing up and down, and it's just awful for these stages. They're the hardest stages and the worst ones to play. So these stages get way, way harder. The screens are basically filled with asteroids and mines and crap. Although that scan, if you get locked on, you're pretty much dead. That's what happened last time. And I think this wet section of the screen is no trouble for random. So that's always cool. So you'd be sitting in the corner, and then you get this locked on. That's no good. Here we go. The jankest fighting. The jankest fighting game ever made. The one fighting. Oh yeah, it doesn't even tell you all the controls for this. It says and more. swear a shield doesn't work like half the time anymore. They'll just shield when they want to. There's a lot of input reading going on in this fighting game. Missile is basically useless, they just dodge it all the time. You don't remember a time machine? Me either. Also, did stream rip? Of course, I never watched this show. Quap fighter, basically, yeah. Your melee attack for your A and your shield button are the same, by the way. I think the best way I've found to do this is use this shot. Bait out their shield and hit them with that. But they also really like the input read. Also hitboxes. Well, I shielded, but I still got hit. Why would she not know what her teammate looks like? And now they're committing vandalism. Here's where shit starts to get serious with all these fucking rocks. I think it's this stage, or the one after it. This is pretty pretty much the strat you have to do. Just shoot all these rocks and sit in the corner. That was quick. Wow. Another one of these things right away. This has even more rocks. These stupid things. Also, the music in this game is really good. I like the music. Dad, walk right. The platform, the, I guess you could call it a platformer, is pretty bad. I think there's one of those stages after this, and it's a sewer level, because those are always great. But, basically cool now at that time. Why is Mars off in space? Okay. Also, your hitbox is pretty much the entire mech, of course. Thank you. was right in front of that health too. Fortunately, this has infinite continues. I'm gonna die before we get to the first second set of health pickups. Oh yeah, I'm dead. I got locked on. Yes, your hitbox is pretty much the whole ship, the whole sprite. Picking up the health in these stages is so hard because you're constantly bouncing up and down. The camera moves when you move, so it gets kind of disorientating. Good health. It's also kind of hard to tell if these are up or down. Star Fox rings. Better enemies in this and not help. This boss on this stage is like easier than the other boss on this stage. So this just shoots mines. You can just sit around and shoot it. The other one had that stupid instant death lock-on mechanic. They kind of blew it up. All right, I have no idea. Yeah, here we go. We're going in the sewer. Alright, so this is the side scroll. It's like kind of like Ninja Warrior, in that you're only on one plane. You have a shield button, a shoot button which you charge, and a jump button. And there's apparently platforming later. Also, it's a crouch you press left, because you're using up and down to aim the cannon, so you press down or left to crouch. Which actually is kind of neat. Gives you the option to aim this cannon. Right? It's like, we have to make it super obvious he's the dumb one. I waited for a second. He probably would. He thinks he gets more powers. Also, you can't destroy the missiles, you have to shield them, or duck, or jump them. This boss is super hard if you don't know how to cheese it. So you have to like crouch, destroy that first or the middle pod right away, and then well, I guess I could have shielded, but it's a rough boss. Took a few attempts. I do like the guy that comes from the ceiling, wherever he is. He's coming off of it. There he is. Pretty cool enemy. That's the boss. If you don't cheese it, it's pretty much possible. Like, you have to cheese the boss. wolf is still lost in the sewer. Oh, he actually is lost in the sewer. Good. Fantastic. Also, some of these stages you can't go up for some reason. Like in the asteroid stages, you can go up and down. But the sky stages, you can't. No, he's lost in the sewer. Because why wouldn't it be? Can Bronski even read? That's a good face. That's a good face too. I like how this guy's not even animated. They didn't even bother. Also, woo, going AWOL. We're disobeying military orders. We're gonna go to jail. Why are they blue? And then destroy it. These cutscenes are getting longer than I thought they would be. So I think it's this stage is bullshit. There's a segment at the end where you constantly take damage. You can't really do anything about it. Also, we have to stop to shoot the door. That was a lucky dog. Shielding time there. Oh, really bad. That works. I didn't know you could just destroy the missile on it. Door, who's boss? Desecrate this carcass. This one Yeah, here we go. Here's this floor. You have to pretty much just jump constantly. Smash shield. Damage is just like unavoidable. I feel like there's a lot of unavoidable damage in this game. Hello. Kaneki, I know, right? It's the best mech walk. I was about to see if that works. Password 1. Job, Bronski, you broke it. Why'd you type all those asterisks, Skolgan? So we got another fighting game. Out their shield and then shoot them. That was one of the stats I found. Also, their legs don't have a hitbox for whatever reason. And it's just the torso of the mech that has a hitbox. mean, that sounds perfectly reasonable to me, and right? Like, they want to advance their civilization with time travel. Sure, go for it. Meanwhile, these jackholes are committing war crimes and disobeying orders. Yeah, you get another fighting game right after, and I swear this part just beats your inputs like crazy. Way more aggressive. JC didn't, I don't know. I'm afraid I can't answer that question. Bite-sized cookies do sound pretty good, though. I think this is where I got in the Cusa Grande. I think this is the stage I got here. I got here in about the same amount of time, but I'm watching the cutscenes this time, which are really long. Yeah, those little tanks do a ton of damage. I think I've seen mini cookies, but they're like really, really expensive compared to normal cookies for whatever reason. Like the mini bags of Chips Ahoy are $4 and you can get a sleeve of them for like $2. So you can't move during this part. Also, yeah, take damage to that dude that you don't know is there. And a lot of this stuff can only be destroyed with charged weaponry. Mini cookies and standard would be great. Cookie Crisp. Now I kind of want a box of Cookie Crisp, even though I know I'm not going to eat it. What the fuck is this thing? Why is it annoying? Why did I just lose 6 bars of health? I know why, because this game. What are y'all, I mean, regeneration? The absurd amount of damage you take in this game? Side note, we already have, like, at least prototypes of cybernetic eyes, which I think is cool. Imagine being able to just shut your eyes off and go to sleep. That would be great. So I love all these foreground objects, and it apparently gets worse. That's a different death sprite. Oh, he didn't die. Okay. He was just sitting there. Sure. I guess, but I more meant like complete darkness. That's a lot of fucking messes. Yeah, VR eyes. It's a dark. I hope that's the next stage. I'll be right back. Oh boy, another one of these stages. I know, right? Like, oh, we're just time traveling, whatever, committing war crimes, who cares? No, man, I didn't. There are no checkpoints in these stages. Oh, that's a big health bar. Big boy bar. That's not even the end of the stage, oh boy. Why is the stage still going? Oh god, another one of whatever the hell that is. Of course it has lock on. Why wouldn't it? Like it moves right here. There we go. I don't know. I don't know why he's off in space while they're destroying society. I am glad that stage is over. Hell. Wait, wrong game. Apparently there are 16 stages in this game. I think we're what? I think this is 14. So not much left. And there aren't any recorded playthroughs, so this is world record, I guess. Something. If JC didn't have a mech, I'm pretty sure he'd keep his coat on. I would. Robots do so much damage. Like, everything just generates you in this. Might be best just to know because they do a ton of damage and they have a ton of health. So why don't you get a mech in Deus Ex? There's a lot of them all over the place. Stop these forces. Really hate these foreground tubes. Maybe. If it was some kind of kryptonite-proof mech, I could see Superman using one. It's the same exact strat works. Nice. But that's only like a minute or something. Well, that was the stage. That was really short and easy compared to the last one. Seems so happy about all this murder he just committed. Are we sure Exo Squad is the good guys? And the Matrix really went downhill when they cloned Neo a lot and turned him blue. Also, the buttons in this are context sensitive. You can either shoot or do a light punch, depending on how close you are. Up and C is a front flip. Also, they'll wait for your shield to run out before shooting. Pretty much. There's a dedicated button to laying down. Then you put a, I don't know how you're supposed to put your foot up, but you do that to grab them out of the air. Let's roll at them. Rolling always seems never mind. What was that? Why did I get turned around? There we go, there's the ground throw. Said he blew it up. I'm pretty sure the Exo Squad is the bad guys. He seems so happy about killing all those people that weren't doing anything and could not defend themselves. time travel part is working. It's something. Yeah, they committed war crimes in the past. It was only a minor problem that we killed all those people. It might have been, I don't know. What? Yeah, time travel is hardly ever done right. I can't think of any that are good off the top of my head. Hyper-mover. What all this thing is doing? hope I finish the rest of this stage. I don't want to do all this. Oh god, I'm on this. God damn. That was the end. Good. Oh, we got platforming now. Can I walk over? I can use the dead dude as a platform. That's great. Also did like no damage. thought I'd fallen in the hole. There and took that. Let's use this guy as a platform. Casually saunter over that corpse. I guess it wants you to jump over that one, but it's too big. Play Marsh. So I guess we're leaving Rita. No, she's here. Does Wolf even know where East is? Because he couldn't find North earlier. See Vita's sick tattoo. I didn't hit anything. The fight just started. At all. There was less input reading in that fight than there were the other three. casually walks up and starts wailing on him. Wish my cannon was that strong. Unfortunately for them, Bronski can't tell time. I don't know. That's the good question. I think they don't, and that's why they're like all made in tubes. Dead, not to move. Also, Rita's dead. Right, they have a time machine. They could travel back to time and find the scientist that's creating Neo Sapiens and shoot him in the face, and then they wouldn't exist at all. If they really wanted to, they could travel back in time to the invention of time machines and stop that. also nice putting the enemy behind the wall there. This has been a lot more than 16 stages. Also, what is with these bullet hell enemy swarms? Well, I can't move during that. Foreground stuff. Oh boy, here's the chain link bits I was told about. There's something hiding behind this fence too. Yep. Just right behind the gate where you can't see it. Now that I know it's there. Can't see this one at all, though. Show this Neo Sapien what for? Context. I'd like a screenshot of that too, please. Oh, was what's-his-face gonna sacrifice himself or some shit. His face is like, oops! But that's what he intended to do. Maybe we should use our time machine and save Rita. An anti-serum? You mean the poison? I'm pretty sure they confused antidote and serum. Oh yeah, the pits are instant death, and Hello Gundam, yeah, you missed it, but there's always the VOD, which I'm considering highlighting and putting on YouTube. But I think this is the last stage, I'm not sure. So if this is the last stage and they show you it in the demo, that's something. Excuse me? 1cc, please, no. This game is too bullshit to 1cc. Like, I'm sure you could, but actually doing it. Also, my favorite thing, you can just use the corpses as platforms. Instant death pits and a walk right platform section. Also, these foreground objects, those are real cool. Well, that was a fast missile. But yeah, we watched all the cutscenes, Gundam. It's real dumb. It's real, real dumb. There's time travel and other stupid shit. The Exo Squad committed a bunch of war crimes and then got mad about it. I had fun with it when I did my Cusa Grande match. And yeah, when I was doing my match, I was doing audio for the restream, so I didn't have my microphone on. And it was a tournament match, so I couldn't really pay attention to chat anyway. Thank you. I did get first in my match, though, so that's cool. This missile is so fast, that's bullshit. That's what it is. I still don't know if that's a hole or not, so I'm gonna jump over it. Just use this man as a platform. I don't know when my next match is gonna be, since round 2 is still going on. I'll be in round 3 next. Shit. I gotta do the whole stage all over again. There are no checkpoints. That's why I don't want to 1cc this, because this is jank. This is real jank. Difficulty wise. You also missed the quapped fighting game, I think. What is that? What is that at the end of the stage? I assume that's the end of the stage. Thank you. very much a game where you get generated. Macaw style. So that sound for the super shot sounds familiar. Like some super scope or something. Or Phalanx. Did I just fall in the hole, or what just happened? Again, we have a time machine. We can go back in time to before Rita got captured. And not do all of this. So yeah, you have like no room to step off of those. You have to jump with the mech on it, pretty much. Like, I'm sure with enough time, you could just pull forward in this game and shoot when you need to. Wow, really? But I don't think I like this game enough to like actually learn it that much, you know? Couldn't watch the horrible cutscenes in a speedrun, and it was like the main reason to play this. Oh yeah, they have jump jets on their mechs. They can fly. Why is he walking? That is a good point, Skolden. I hit shield. The game said I didn't, but I did. They could just fly to the lab. And not do this slow, plodding walk. Fell in the hole. I Why are we not using our time machine to warn Rita? Why is this fucking thing still alive? Why are there foreground objects that block some of the jumps? Bridge with this man. Why do enemies do so much contact damage? That's the thing that upsets me the most. Like, your health is just gone if an enemy touches you. What is this? What is that? Why is that part a thing? Just constant missiles and a dude shooting at you on the floor. Crap being dropped on you. That's a hole or not, I don't trust it. Like, the mine's doing 2 bars, sure, I could understand that. They're mines. They're made for. But the tiny little, what looks like a scouting robot, doing as much damage as it does. That was what, 2 bars? Oh well, I guess that's not infinite then. So we just wait for that and not have that man shoot your feet. So that's good. I really hope that's the last boss, or at least the boss of the stage. Cause those things were just flying around hitting me, and it was awful. They look indestructible. Oh, there's more game. But at least there's a different stage. By different stage, I mean they're using the exact same background for the lab. Also, what is this music? Music does not fit the rest of this game's soundtrack at all. This sounds like something you'd hear in a cool spot. Or like Chester Cheeto or something. Or some kind of horrible Sonic knockoff. You are not fast enough to dodge that with this game's controls and the way they respond. At least you have infinite continues. Because I would not finish this game if you didn't have infinite continues. It's upsetting how unfitting this music is. Supposed to react to that. Wow. Wow, game. That's rude, putting that sentry gun there, where it would totally hit you, when you're going to get help and when you're probably almost dead. Stage. Hopefully the end of the game. You came here to get an antidote. Why are you blowing up the laboratory? I got the anti-serum for Rita. Fuck everybody else. Time machine. The time machine you could have used to fix all this before it got this bad. Our heroes made it back safely to their own time after committing several dozens of war crimes. Good! Finally, somebody makes some sense in this game. They destroyed all the time machines. Because we forced them to. They're making orcs? I guess that's neat. Password to the film. There's a movie, guys. I guess that's just to watch the ending movie again. That's it, I guess. That's the game. It was fun, but I don't think I'll ever play it again. Let's see who's live. alive. Let's see. Well, Kilgore just started doing Lands of Lore, which is a pretty dank game, so I'll host Kilgore. So thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time.